Previously, we went through combining shapes. In this video, we're going to look over how to subtract shapes. Here, I put a red box on the work plane. If you look at the top of the basic shape list, there are a pair of boxes and cylinders. If you bring the first shapes on the work plane, you can notice these are transparent with diagonal patterns. It's blinking on the top of the shapes because they have same heights. This transparent shape is called whole shape, which has subtract function. The whole shape makes the overlap part subtracted. It would be more convenient to make whole shapes higher than others and locate them visibly. Resizing, rotating, etc. All the functions we did in previous videos are applied to this whole shape too. So I put them like this and select all together by drag. You need to select all shapes, including the main body and whole shapes. Then, click the Group button. You can see the overlap whole shapes are gone. This is the subtracting in Tinkercad. As you can guess, you can do ungroup and modify whole size or quantity again. Putting whole shapes doesn't mean anything. Don't forget to group them together. Grouping is the finish line of subtracting. By the way, there are a bunch of shapes in the list, but why there are only box and cylinder for subtracting? Did you remember how to change the color of shapes? Yes, click Solid in the panel. Next to the solid icon, there is whole section. If you click this, every shape loses their color and becomes the whole shape for subtracting. That means you can use every shape as a whole shape. I bring heart shape on the work plane. The whole shape will subtract the overlapped part. In other words, whole shape makes a hole through the main body. Or, if you leave the bottom and move it a little bit up in Z-axis, you can check the difference. Let's select them by drag and group it. Left one is the hole through the main body, but the other is a heart-shaped container. According to the location of hole shape, you can make a hole or a shaped container. As I told you, you can do rotate, copy, and paste, and so far to whole shapes as same as basic shapes. I put this box hole shape and rotate 45 degrees. Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V, V, V. Copy and paste several boxes here. These whole shapes also can be grouped together. It makes one big whole shape. Now, I have one big zigzag whole shape. How many whole shapes you can have depends how you use shapes in different ways. With grouping, I made a wiki character. The thing is that I can also use this new character as a whole shape. Use this shape as a whole shape again. All you need to do now is to decide you're gonna make it engraved or embossed. Using whole shapes in various ways, you can make tens of thousands of shapes only with basic shapes.